A random bit of political comment, stuck to a fence. It's a sentiment it's difficult to find fault with. Anyway, we're at Pallion, above the Northern Spire Bridge, with the intention of making our way upstream along the River Weir to South Hylton. Before we start, though, behind us is the course of a lost stream, known as Lady's Gill, which once flowed down to join the Weir. It may still run underground. Manhole covers at the top of the slope, and here at the bottom, suggest a possible course. Be that as it may, there was a lot of rain last night, and earlier this morning. As a result, there's actually water running in the course of this lost stream, as if it's trying to reassert itself and its place in the landscape. Anyway, onwards. Here, always dodgy in wet weather, has been made much worse by dickheads on motorcycles. It's not the kind of path you want to go slip-sliding around on, not with an unfenced drop down to the river on one side. Made it safely down, without mishap. I think it's about an hour after high tide. An industrial relic beckons. I think it was probably a lime kiln. I assume those are lens flares. Or, is it the site's guardian? That impressive cliff face. That's Clexheugh Rock. Spelled Claxheugh, but pronounced Clexheugh. A love brick. Which sounds like something you get from a fetish shop, but is actually just a brick manufactured in the brickworks of Victorian businessman Joseph Love, who owned Shincliffe Colliery and Brick Works in County Durham. Love was a staunch Methodist, and such was his desire to spread the word of his version of God, he would, allegedly, sack any of his workforce who were Catholics. Love by name, but not so much by nature. Anyway, these are quite collectible, at least among brick collectors. There was one on eBay going for 18 quid. Oh look. There goes another ghost. It all looks fairly rural now, but this was once an industrial hotspot, with a paper mill, cement works and other stuff down here. There was even a sports ground. This is a salt marsh. Despite its obvious impact on the landscape, the rock doesn't seem to have generated any folklore. Happily, it's not even a spot favored by suicides. Thank you. industrial relics. There's one of the original River Weir Trail information boards. Must be at least 30 years old. The council lost interest in promoting it a long time ago, but the occasional relics still exist. That's North Hylton on the far bank. Those old hulks have been there as long as I can remember. North Hylton is basically a pub, one or two houses, and not a lot else. The bridge carries the A19, the road we can never escape for long. There was probably a bridge here in Roman times. Some have seen evidence of Roman stonework along the river. The Golden Lion Pub, South Hylton. Or what remains of it. It was destroyed in an arson attack in 2019. Though I think it had been closed for a couple of years before that. The building is early 20th century, but was on the site of an older Golden Lion. The doorway is older than the building. It's said to commemorate the marriage of John Hylton and Dorothy Musgrave, and was originally from Hylton Castle. The remains were said to have been sold at auction for 61 grand several years ago. But nothing seems to have been done with it, and the for sale board is still up. I think that probably had something to do with the ferry that used to ply its trade here. The rock in the boat is a sculpture, though I forget who by. There is actually a pedestrian footpath across the bridge. It's not very pleasant and can be a bit scary sometimes. But if you want to cross the river here, it's the only game in town. It's good to get away from the traffic noise. The bustling metropolis that is North Hylton. That's the side of the pub. Now, let's head back along the north bank. We have to head away from the river at this point. Following this little burn. Until it vanishes into a pipe. Happily, we can get away from the traffic again almost immediately. Thank you. The Wreck of the Cretan Hauser. And here we are, back at the Northern Spire Bridge. There's the mouth of the Hylton Dean Burn. And across the river from it. Could this pipe be the outlet for Nadi's Gill, the lost stream we noted at the start of the video? Although there's something else discharging into the weir nearby. Perhaps that's the stream, and the pipe is its industrial. It could be either, or possibly neither. Well, anyway, we've just about come full circle, and also reached the conclusion of this video. Hope you enjoyed the trip. Goodbye.